Okay, welcome in, everybody. I am Sweet Bobby, aka Dr. Bobby Gaines, or I'm Dr. Bobby Gaines, aka Sweet Bobby, the world's worst trader, but I ain't as bad as I used to be. Welcome in, Trader Nerds. Hope you're having a fabulous day. If we have anybody that's joining us from the Tasty Trade Facebook group, welcome. I thought it'd be a good day to invite you guys in. Y'all bored to death, got nothing else to do, than to hang out with us nerds and do a little trading. So what we do, our philosophy is we are much better when we track what we do. So a lot of people don't track their trades and they just throw things out and hope they stick. What we do is we try to track things and we're more successful doing it. Now, one of the areas that I'm very good at is in tracking my trades. One area that I'm not good at is tracking my food metrics. But this is kind of the same thing, right? So now, y'all don't look at that. That's just when I had my phone on me, right? I got more than 2,000 steps yesterday, right? Beth? Maybe she's making a sandwich or something. So you see, my trainer gives me a calorie budget of 2,224. So yesterday, old Sweet Bobby logged everything in, and I had 2,278 calories. So I went over by 54. So it's not like this is red. This is kind of orange going, look, man, your analysis is if you keep doing this, you're going to have a slower loss. So I had 758 for breakfast, 254 for lunch, and I had a great baked potato with barbecue pork, sour cream, cheese, and everything. And I was like, man, I was putting the pork on it. I was putting the cheese on it. I'm trying to increase my protein like she wants me to because she wants me to have 40% of my food coming from protein. She said, Bobby, at least 30. And look, I only did 17%. She says, you got to cut this fat down, dude. You get your fat down a little bit and, you know, get your carbs down a little bit. So if I could have just took 13% from this and added 13% here, I'd have got my four. But I had a protein shake yesterday. I mean, it's hard getting in the protein. But you realize that if I track my food and if you track your food, your health will be better. Your weight will be better if you track all of this stuff. And a lot of times we don't do it. And then if we do it, we stop doing it. And then our, what? Okay, drive carefully, hon. I only got $25,000 of life insurance on you. Drive carefully. All right, so you see what I'm saying? So this is kind of, you know, it's important to track stuff, kind of keep up with, you know, how we're doing. So we do that in trading too. Now, I have got away from it and I've abandoned it at times. And every time I do, you know, I'm the world's worst trader. I do worse. So it helps me when I track my metrics and I keep up with it. So what we've developed is this wonderful little spreadsheet that helps us to keep up with all of our metrics. So this is the same thing. Now, it's not as pretty as the little MyNet diary I showed you on my food groups there. But, you know, this is as pretty as I can make it in an Excel spreadsheet. So we see, you know, that's blue, that means we're cool. Green means we're right on. Red means we're overbound. And then we do the same thing that we do with our weight with our portfolio, right? So why don't we, let's even look at the market. We spend way too much time looking at the market, I think. We don't care what the market does. All we know is our best technical analysis is our big green monster. And how many times do we see the big green monster inflection points right at where we draw the big green? Is that amazing? I mean, I told y'all, I said, y'all, we going to 38.85. And I told y'all that when we was here, right? I said, y'all, we going to 38.85. And what does it do? Pivots from there. Then we may go back. But we all know to keep an eye on the red line, which is the point of control and volume. We all know that when you see these gaps, that we're going to fill some of those gaps. So when you see a little bit down move or a flat move to fill these gaps, you got to think this is a vacuum for price. The kids got, we got the dogs cut yesterday, their hair and stuff, and they got them dressed up in their dog clothes. So that's just sad. So we figured that these areas will be touched, right? And we're never surprised to see us go back to the point of control because this is where volume has been traded. People were comfortable trading here. And that 3698, so call it 3700 level, is something that's always in our radar as long as that's the point of control. All right. So let us go and update all of our little counts here. So let's see, this one, let me hide it so I don't show the account number. That's what they don't let me show. Let's see, can I do that? Right, here we go. So this account has, I don't know what I'm doing here. Okay, so this one has 35. Let me find the right spreadsheet. Hasty works. Let's do it first. Netlick. And this one is 10, 27, 22. And we've got 35, 892 even. How about that? We're never even. So, y'all, that looks like we're up $66 today. Praise the Lord Jesus.
We're moving on up.
We're moving on up.
To the east side.
We're
moving on up. In a deluxe apartment in the sky.
So, let's bring it up. I want the crowd, man. Uh-oh. Can I get that? What are y'all talking about there? That's probably where we're headed after Apple misses tonight. Exactly. Because y'all know. I mean, Apple's going to miss too, because since what's-his-name died, we can't even get a, here's Apple's big announcement every year. Oh, we got a new color phone, or oh, we added a camera. Well, hoop-de-freaking-do. Right? So there's no real innovation coming out of Apple anymore. Look at our deltas, y'all. Is this incredible? We are trading bullish strategies, and we got a negative four delta. So let's put that in. Negative four. And our theta is a beautiful 35. It's not too beautiful, though, is it? 35. Well, that's better than it was yesterday. Oh, look at there, y'all. We're at 0.1, but I guess rounding-wise, we're still a little cool. So this pretty much tells me, yeah, Bob, you need to put on a trade. What's the VIX today? VIX is 26.98. I'll call it 26. I don't round. I'm round myself with my body type. I don't need to round. So we could be as high as 0.30. Our buying power usage is, I got the right account, dude. 87.46. So we're using 24% of our buying power. We could be as high as 35. Our deltas are negative four. They could be as high as 72. And I mean, this is just great. It's just telling me, hey, Bob, put on a trade, dude. Yeah. So I don't need to know what direction the market's going. So let's put on our little trade table. We go, is that 50 days today? I got to log out and do this right. Long put vertical. So for those of you that are new, this is what we call a 112 trade, right? There's 111, 112. I guess you could do a 113, however you want to do it. But we do 50-point wide strikes in the MES. We got a larger account, go into the ES. We love our S&P 500 stuff. Make them 50 points wide. And we're going to go where this is about 10 bucks, and I don't overlap strikes. So there's $10. To get filled, I'm probably going to have to go to 10 and a quarter. And I'm fine with that. We'll just fill in those strikes at 10 and a quarter and buy our little put down. All right, so we got our butt dip express. And now we got to go sell some puts to pay for that. So that cost us $10. So we normally go down to where we find something around $10, right? But I'm a little bit greedy. So I'm gonna go right here, maybe this 1175, and we'll sell two of the 3180s, move that to the mid price. Do two of these, 3180s. Ta-da! And we're filled. That's it. That's all I got to do in this account. I am done for the day. Isn't that cool? I got nothing else to do. If there's an Apple miss, $2 trillion plus market cap headache to digest. Yeah. I mean, it could be big. So, and I know what some of y'all are doing. Some of y'all are going, hell, I ain't putting a trade in until tomorrow. Wait till I see what Apple does. What you waiting on? You got to take a little risk, though. You got to put in trades. If your metrics say take a trade, but don't put a trade in. We don't trade news around here. We trade what's in front of us. Everything's perfectly priced right now. Is Apple a member of the S&P 500? Yeah. Did Tesla take us down today? No, not really. I mean, not Tesla. What's it? What's Meta. Stupid Meta didn't take us down at all. So I think we're fine. I said, we'll move this over to the side. Oh, don't forget, in 50 minutes, you and I will be doing a mastermind session. This is for all Muscadine Mafia members in our Discord room, right? How champions think, Coach Nick Saban, and process thinking. So we're going to talk about process thinking and applying that to our trades. So that is in 50 minutes. We're going to have a great time there. It's going to be really, really good. I've been thinking a lot about this. I was sitting there going, special teams. What's the football? You know, what's scoring a touchdown? What is defense? What is offense? So we're going to talk about all that. We're going to talk about breaking our trading into processes. But hey, what's the plural of process? Anyway, y'all know what I'm talking about. All right, so let's go to our thinkorswim account. So I guess we'll do the IRA first. So we'll go up here, and I figured out how I can show y'all, but so y'all don't think I'm lying about my nickname. So this one is 103,782.
103,782. Well, we're moving on up. We're moving on up to the east side. To a deluxe apartment in the sky.
All right, so let's get our Greeks and ratios over here. And for those of y'all that think, oh, man, he has to go through a lot of stuff. Look, y'all, it's easy, though, really, to do it, right? So our delta is 2012, and that's 75. 2012. And 75 in theta. And I think y'all saw me yesterday. I actually put on another trade, and I posted it in the room after our time together. So I was even putting on more trunch. I cannot get this to 0.1, y'all. I just can't. What is my problem? What was that, 27 or so? So our buying power is 25,593. Gosh, I just can't get this count to do anything. 25,593. So we are at 24%, could be at 35%. So, you know, a lot of y'all will go, well, when Apple crashes tomorrow, you'll be up 35%. I don't know that. I don't know if Apple crashes. I don't know what the market does. I just got a trade in front of me now. So saying I need a trade, right? So the market is flat right now. It's flat. So let's go do the same trade in this account within the other account. And I may, you know, just to get my theta up a little bit, I may put two tranches on. We'll see. All right, so let's do it in the micros. Some of y'all are really probably flipped out going, wait a minute, you're trading futures? Aren't those scary? No, not really. We want you to get used to them. So we'll do the same strikes. So we'll do two of the 3180s. I think I'm going to do 3180s. Look how much the market's been going up. Two of the 3180s. Do I want to do four of these? I think I do. We'll do four of those, and let's move up to the mid price of 1250. So, but come on, baby, feel me. Here we go. We're filled at 1250. Let's go put that in our spreadsheet. In the S, we did two. And we'll call these naked put 15. And we did the 3180s. Puts naked 50 days, 10, 27, 22. And we filled that for 1250. Wow, look at that nice credit. We did 1225 yesterday. So we got 1250 on those. So let's go do the spread. So I did, oh, wait a minute, I did four of those, didn't I? Let's make sure. Four of those at 1250. Yeah. Come here, baby. Four of those at 1250. Not two, four. Uh-oh. Not two, but four, Bob. So I brought in a beautiful credit of $244.12. So now let's do our put debit spread. So we'll go over here, trade, and we'll do the 3580, 3530. Uh-oh. Yeah. I guess it doesn't matter anymore, does it, about the overlapping? It help me think if this is okay. We normally don't like overlapping stripes. I would never sell one where I bought one. So I think what I'm going to do is, since I've already bought one here, I can buy another, since now we're grouping them differently. So I think I'm fine with that. Buy the 3580. I've already got one loan there. And I'm going to sell the 3530, right, for a $10 debit. And we've got to do two tranches of this, right, to make it a 112. Feel me? Let's go 10 and a quarter.
Bobby, while you're working that, I think the reason you're not overlapping strikes is mainly a Tastyworks phenomenon, because it stops you from grouping those effectively and destroys whatever other grouping you've done online. Is that basically?
Yeah, that's basically it. And I still would not sell one where I'm loaned one. Now, synthetically, works out.
Well, then you're wiping out a put debit spread or whatever, and you're creating effectively a much wider. If you have two put debit spreads that are 50 and you come in, you wipe out part of one of those put debit spreads, all you've really done is create a wider put debit spread than you had before. You haven't created two of them.
Right.
And I just wanted to make sure that the main reason that you didn't overlap strikes was we'll call it the Tasty phenomenon more than anything.
Yeah, where I couldn't group them. And I didn't do it in Thinkorswim either, because when I was putting them in the individual groups, when I was closing the trade, it might take it out of the other group. And it was like,
exactly.
It was a pain in the butt. But now that we're doing this alternate universe of grouping trades, I think we're fine doing it.
Okay. I just wanted to throw out there for my own purpose, as well as everyone listening, that was the main reason. Okay.
Yeah, because I don't know how confusing this could be to someone that is tuning in for the first time. And I'm always trying to be mindful of that. I don't want to scare people off, because we've got a great little strategy going here. And we'll show you.
I think that's a legitimate concern. I'm still getting feedback from existing people that, you know, I'm not totally following this. And I just encourage people to continue grouping them like they were being grouped here a couple of weeks ago and before.
Can I show y'all something? Now, here's what I like about this, right? So for those of you that are here every day, you normally see us open the profit calendar. We're closing trades all the time. It's been a long time, y'all, since we closed the trade. So we're taking them to expiration after we found out, hey, this kind of works better, right? Taking these trades to expiration. So I just want you to look. And we've just recently done this, last 2 weeks or so? I want you to see what's happening with my net leg, just this month. Let's just see what's happened to the net leg of this account just this month. So 103.782 is where we're at now. 782, right? 103.782. Where were we on the last day of September, right? So September, we were at 98.904. So minus 98,904.89. Okay. So we've made in our net leg is up $5,000 on a $100,000 account. So that would be 4877 divided by 98,904.89 is 4.93%. Now, when I did this yesterday, I told Ed about it. I said, Ed, I was so excited about being up 4.9% until I saw that the market was up like 6.9 or whatever I told you it was. It was up 6 whatever. That's fine though, y'all. I think that's fine because, you know, we're still positioned to the downside, whereas the market is not. So since we've been doing this with the market, how are we doing? Since we started this, now, of course, we did a bunch of dumb trades in here, but the 111, we have closed. This is realized profits. We made $7,742.20. So since the market has, even though we did our dumb trades too, even in the same time period, the market's down 14.59%. We're up 2.06. And that's with the dumb trades. And we should be up much more than 2.06 if we'll stop the dumb trades, which I've stopped. The dumb trades have stopped. We're just doing 111, 112. I don't need anything else. No credit, spreads, no SPX, no, no. We're just doing the plan, working the plan. Questions on that? 5% a month, I'll take it all day long. Dang right, Stacy. Heck yeah. And the thing is, we're going to overperform the market when the market slugs to the downside. That's what's really cool, right? So I like our new management style. And we're doing it in a very, very conservative way. That's what's cool. So, I mean, is this the Holy Grail? No. But I think it's the closest that I've ever seen. I mean, we've been doing this since August of 21, y'all. And I've never seen anything work this way. And if I had known, if I had listened to Stacy months ago, Stacy, I'll bring this up probably for the rest of our lives. If I listened to Stacy and said, yeah, Bob, you need to really start taking these to an expiration. And I thought, yeah, whatever, Stacy. I should have listened to it. All right. Isn't that great? All right. So then here's what you do, right? So you go over here and we've got a new grouping. If you're first time with us, we do group our trades. So kind of cool that we go, okay, let's put our naked put. So we got these unallocated ones, right? This is the naked ones. So I'm going to move that to the naked group. And then I'm going to move the put debit spread to put debit spread. How about that? Cool, right? Cool, cool, cool. All right, so that count's done. I ain't got to do anything. I can go cut the grass. I can go lay out in the sun. I can, you know, get my nails did. There's all kinds of stuff I could do with that. I ain't got to do nothing else. I'll look at it again tomorrow. So this is why I think this resonates with a lot of people, right? You can do this from your office. You can do this from your phone. You ain't got to have, I mean, you can figure out your ratios and all the night before. If you don't have access to a spreadsheet, you can do it with a pencil. We've shown you how to do that. Just track your stuff and, you know, trade your plan. All right, let's go to the other camp and see what we're doing there. Let's play the Jeffersons one more time, I hope. Let's see what our net lick is over here in the smaller account. So over here, our net lick is 26,879. So here it is, 26,879. We're playing the Jeffersons just about every darn day, right? On all these accounts. Y'all probably getting tired of hearing this.
Well, we're moving on now.
We're moving on up
to the east side. To a deluxe apartment in the sky.
All right, so let's take our groups off so we can get our metrics.
Hey, Bobby, I think you got some numbers transposed.
Uh-oh, on did I do something wrong? Let me see.
I think.
26,9 something, wasn't it? Hold on.
I think it was 879.
879. Yeah, let's go. Just make sure.
Is that right?
26,884. Okay, 26,884. Must have been 26,884. That's even better. Kind of makes me want to play the Jefferson scheme. I'll hold up. What did they say? I don't know. Okay, thank you, Stacy, so much. Which leads me to believe, Rick, what is your problem? Rick normally catches those things. Rick, what the devil? Rick, are you sleeping? Has mama got you working around the house? See, he's sleeping. Now, here we go. Mama's got Rick doing some. 986 is our deltas. And are y'all noticing, you know, how our deltas have become muted since we do this new kind of strategy? It's really cool. Let's see what our theta is. Theta is 30.68. Okay, and I think that was around 27, 26. Doesn't matter. It's in between those things. So, buying power over here is a little high yesterday, right? So 85.85. Let's see where we're at. This one will be interesting to see if we need to do something. 85.85. So we are at 32%, y'all. We're 32%, you know, green. So what I could do is say, you know, we got some that are expiring. Let's just kind of look. If I add risk today, let's go to analyze tab. And what you could do, hide simulations, right? So you're looking at all your positions. And then over here, go to the first series, right? So here's the first series. So here's all my positions. Oh, I know why I did that. Okay, so there's all my positions. Let's do those off. and let's do just my first level of position. So it looks like it's just one trade. And these are coming off in how many days? About five or so? 4 days. I got 4 days left on this. How much buying power is this particular trade taking off? So I'm going to free up. It was like 400 yesterday, right? Yeah. So today it's like $700 of buying power. Okay. In 4 days, that'll be released. And do y'all see that gorgeous profit tent? Look at that, y'all. Let's move this to the 27th. It's going to pop up even. Look at that. I mean, we want a 5% pullback. We want a 5% pullback. Isn't that cool? I think I'm going to put a trade on today. What would y'all do? I mean, my Greeks say, and like, sure, I may go, if we get a good move to the downside, you know, things may swell and I may get up a little bit, but I think I'm fine. Well, I want it to come down. I can take this one off and release some buying power. Look at this thing, though. Y'all, this one has, it's given me negative theta, which we kind of don't like, but everything else is just beautiful. I mean, it's just sitting there ready for mama to just come down 5%. Oh, come down even less than that. Come right here. Right. Ed was talking about this yesterday. He goes, Bobby, I've never traded a strategy where I want the market to go down. He said, it's amazing. I want it to go down to put on new positions. I want it to go down to, you know, for my net leg to go up. I mean, this is crazy. I've never experienced anything like this. It's just fun. All right. So why don't we put on new trade? Come on, Bob. Are you a man or are you an Auburn fan? Huh? Which one? Sorry, if any of y'all are off with me. All right, so let's go over here and get our trades. Let's just do the same thing, except we're not going to do this many, right? So I'm going to do a duplicate order. And I'm going to go to the 1250 again. We can get filled there. 1250, and we're going to reduce this to 2, right? So do confirm and send, and then make sure you change your account. So we're going to put that in the Crimson account. And swing. There we are. Let's go back to the other account. And let's grab that put debit spread. Now, some of y'all are freaking out because I did the naked first. I ain't scared. What am I scared of? So let's do the put debit spread. Create duplicate order. So if that's still going for, oh, no. 1075. Ooh, behave. I'm still going to see if I can get it in for 10 feet. And then we're going to reduce this to one tranche and put it in the crimson camp. Come on, baby. Hit me with your best shot. Okay, they're going to make me pay for it. Aha! You scoundrels, you scallywags. All right, 1050 on that one. And 1250 on the other. Let's go put that one in. Do any of y'all track y'all's food every day? Your exercise? Y'all tracking that stuff? It helps, right? I used to be 464 pounds. I am 328 pounds today. So I am doing pretty good. So let's see. PBS. I'm gonna put my naked put. Hold on. Make sure I got this right. I got 2 naked puts. I can't remember what I'm doing. 2 naked puts. Naked puts 10. Thank you, man. I appreciate that. And naked puts were 3180. Puts. That used to be a big old joke. Big old joker. I'm still a big old joker, but I'm 6'2", used to be 6'4". Before my car accident, I had to have spinal fusion surgery, which I was so excited. I was not excited. I was like, man, you mean I lost 2 inches? And a friend of mine said, Bobby, there's worse places to lose inches. And I said, well, I guess you're right. All right, so 1250. So our naked puts, we got 122.06. And then we got one tranche of our little put debit spread. So let's put him in here. PDS 10. That was the same person that said when I had my toe cut off because I've eat up with the diabetes that He said, there's worse things to get cut off. And I said, well, you put a lot of things in perspective. Thank you. Appreciate it. So 50 days on this. What do we do? 10:50, 10:27, 22, 10:50, I think. 19.50. Okay. So that costs us $55. And we got a credit of $222. That's beautiful. So let's go put them in the groups. And then we're going to admire some stuff. And this is the same account too. This account is up the 4.9% too, just like the other one since the first of this month. So I really like that. So let's put it back in our groups. Show our groups. And unallocated, we'll put this in the naked group. I said we'll put this in the naked group. Move to group. Naked puts. And we'll put our put debit spread. Hold your control key down. Right click. Move to group. Put debit spread. Beautiful. There she is. All right. Let's go back to this account. So here's why we like this account. It's a bullish to neutral strategy that we put on. And the cool part is our little trade over time just becomes a dang beast, y'all. Let's make sure I got them all checked here. Yep. So, you know, you're sitting there going, Bobby, look at all these positions you got on. Yep, yep. We have offensive linemen, we have running backs, and we have quarterbacks. And we'll explain that in the Nick Saban process thinking in about 30 minutes. Isn't that cool? Look at that, y'all. I mean, how can you get any better than that? So you start looking at this thing and you go, oh, behave. I want the market to pull back. And I really, and that's not even the expiration line. Are you kidding me? This is this is just today's line. Make sure I got it on the right day. Let's see, 10:27. Here we go, today. There we go. So here's our Theo line. What's our expiration line look like? Oh, behave. Look, risk is totally shifted to the downside. Is that crazy? That is just crazy. What am I missing, y'all? Okay, so here's today. Here's these things at expiration. Today, expiration. Isn't that cool? And it's like, you know, I could sit here and look at this all day and go, I told Ed the other day, Ed, we built this. Look at this, Ed. Well, this is something we built. Isn't that great? We're all building this together. Ken and Stacy and Rick and Matt Jolly Bolly and Dwayne. We're just all working together, baby, to build something pretty darn special. And it's just good to where you go, man, I wish we'd get a pullback in the market. And you just keep putting trades on as long as the metrics say to. Now, I'm going to go just a couple minutes, since we've got a couple minutes. And I want to go into what I refer to as the weeds. And the weeds was this. You remember when we were looking at this and we go, well, let's just look at our stuff coming off in the next 4 days, right? So we started looking at this and going, what should we do? What should we do? You know, we got 4 day options, and y'all been taught that Tasty Trade says take them off at 21 days. And oh my God, what are we going to do? So let's just check all of our 4 day stuff and just kind of look what it looks like over here. So here's our 4 day options, right? So how does that look? Somebody talk to me. What do I want the market to do in the next 4 days? Anybody got a clue? yeah, I want a pullback. So then we started talking and saying, you know what? I need to start taking some profits in these. So here's what we said. Because I've been praying about this and I've been thinking about it, and I've come up with what I think is my divine intervention, what I'm gonna do. So let's look at the 38.60, 8:10 that we have here. Okay. So here we are today. Look, we're up $81. If the market continues to go up, we are going to lose $50. So what some of you would say is, I'm taking this off, man. I'm going to take my $80 and run. And I'm going to recommend to you, don't do it. Do not do it. Bring these things to expiration. And don't overthink. We got a forest and we got trees. And you call it a garden or whatever you want to. Some of y'all have a tendency, me included, to get on your knees and start pulling weeds when you don't need to. there's nothing for me to do. If it goes down, I'm fine. If it goes up, I'm fine too. So I'm not going to look at these trades individually. That's my plan. I'm not going to look at and close them or do anything unless the metrics of the portfolio dictate that I need to close those. I will not deviate. So I came up with that late last night as I was laying in my bed with my dog laying beside me, who's wearing a dress and a hoodie, even as I speak. I'm not missing it. But Bobby, what if it goes up? I don't care. Because what y'all are doing and what I want to do and you want to do and have our tendency to do is to become trade managers. We're never going to be successful as trade managers. Now, let's just, can I get an amen? Hallelujah. Give me an amen. We're never going to become, manage the trade. Don't manage trade. Manage the portfolio.
Amen, Bobby.
Thank you, man. Manage the portfolio. Don't worry about the trades. So don't you get in these weeds and start pulling weeds, unless that's your thing. If you want to get in the weeds and start pulling, go ahead. But I'm telling you, you don't need to. It is these trades that I've got on that allow me to put on risk behind it. Well, Bobby, that's going to be off in 4 days. Doesn't matter. Whatever the portfolio metrics say, that's how I'm going to build my wealth. That's going to how I'm going to build my wealth. That's going to be how I build my portfolio. I am not looking at the individual trade unless I need to. Now, there's one exception. Let's say all hell breaks loose and we want to. I'm giving myself an exception, right? And my exception is this. Let's say all hell breaks loose and, one trade goes against us. Our strike gets breached. Y'all remember when we did this? And I can still do this. I can still send one of my trades into timeout. I can send him into rehab. This is like, have y'all seen those rehab shows? What is it where they sit around a circle and they do an intervention? I love that show, because they got everybody and their mama's a drug head. And then they, I'm getting out of here, man. Y'all ain't talking to me like this. And then they hug and love and try to get them into rehab the same day. Y'all know what I'm talking about. So if I get one of my naked puts that is breached, my first encounter would be this. What does my portfolio say do? I've always got to defer to my portfolio. But if my portfolio is out of whack and I want to fix it, I still have permission in my written trading plan to put a trade in timeout. Remember this losing trade? This was a problem child, right? And 1/1/1/21st was going against us. We initially got a credit of $155. But then our strike got breached. I had to close that thing for $998. That gave us I can't do the math in my head, $800, $700 loss. So then we sold 6 naked puts and converted it from a 111 into a 112. We took in a credit of $988. Then we closed that initial put debit spread that made us a lot of money, right? We made $684 from that. And then I closed those 6 naked puts for $109. So our total debits. Now, keep in mind, this was a losing trade. This was a problem child. This was one of ours that the strike got breached. We were able to turn a losing trade into a $720 winner. Can we do it again? Yeah. There were people that said, hey, man, you got lucky. No, I didn't. Did not get lucky. I follow a very regimented process. Now, it would have worked if the market had still just kept on going down, we would have rolled out farther. We would have rolled these 6 out, not to 12, but we would have rolled them out farther in time. How could I know that? How could I do this? How could I roll 3 naked puts out to 6? Because my portfolio metrics said I had plenty of buying power to do that. If my portfolio metrics had said, hey, Bob, you don't have the buying power to do that, I would have rolled these out farther in time, improved my Greeks and metrics, and taken no additional buying power rolling those out. And in fact, I probably would have decreased my buying power. So I always now, thanks to Ed, want to keep this rolling and problem child option in my little quiver. It's an arrow in my quiver in case I ever have to go there. But I will always defer to here. Now, here's what tells me where the decision should be made. y'all, is this great or what? Huh? In this account, we've made closed trades after commission, $7,742. We're up more than that now that we are doing this additional management. We're just not, we didn't close them yet. So we'll start having trades close in 4 days, I guess, and we'll enter those into our profit. All right, who's got questions? Y'all so quiet. Ed, why are you so quiet?
I'll pop on. I was trying to hold myself back, but I'll hop on.
You know, Ed, Mama ain't even at home, and you, I think you'd be really loud today.
So, first, thanks for the credit, but I would consider it a group effort. So, any breakthrough developments we have, I think we're all throwing our brain power into the into the pot and whatever.
Hey, and let's mention that while you bring that up. This is a great think tank. It really is. And I do appreciate everybody's contributions, Stacy's and Ken's and Rick's and everybody, Matt's, to making it a really, really good community. I appreciate that. And the way that we work together, and even though I don't listen to Stacy when she told me the last time, you know, we come around eventually.
Well, I think you've reprimanded yourself very nicely and sufficiently on the Stacy issue, and I don't think you'll ever make that mistake again. But you know, a lot of my skills have come from either the Tasty Trade, you know, beginnings of my option trading, which is a lot of people's route, as well as some of these trade management things that I've come up with since coming here, were either Tasty Works related, Tasty Trade related, or interacting with fellow nerds in the community. So there's a lot to be learned from a lot of people out there that, you know, we are part of this, you know, trader nerd think tank. And it's great that we all throw in and get out what we do. And in that regard, I want to be a weed picker. Can I pull a weed?
Pull a weed. Come on.
So I want to go back, if you don't mind, and I know you want to get off. Don't take more than 5 minutes, because I think you should get off and prepare for your next session. But I want you to go back to that trade that's on the edge of the tent.
Tasty Works?
Yeah, I think that's where it was.
Okay.
It's the one you just looked at. It's the one that expires tomorrow, or one of them that expires tomorrow. There you go.
One of our put debit spreads.
So I hear where you're coming from, and I agree with you overall that all these put debit spreads are there for a wall of protection. They are there as insurance. They are there as a shock absorber. That being said, I think when they get very near maturity like this one, I do think they need to be looked at differently. In that right now, this thing's going to be gone tomorrow, or if you were looking at it on Monday and it's going to be gone, say, Friday or something. And based on where this thing is in the tent, you're up 80 and you might be down 50, okay? But if it goes left just a little bit, if we have any kind of pullback at all, this thing could max out for the $200 top profit. So I tend to look at these, first of all, what you're saying is correct. They are the insurance protection for the portfolio. But there should also be a lot of other put debit spread protection for the portfolio right behind this one. And I know there is, and you know there is. So if there's a lot of put debit spread protection, I look at the near-term expirations, as you said, as an area that can be pruned, et cetera. And I think this trade being on the edge of the tent, it's not a good risk reward to take it off. Because if we get a rise in the market, your existing positions will offset the little loss you're going to have here. If we have a decline in the market, this thing is going to go up in value. So a lot. So I think it was marking at 80 and it can go up to 200. So that's a $120 increase or 150% between now and tomorrow. So, you know, this one becomes a 50-50. But if let's say the market price was at, go down to 3,700. Let's say we're at 3,700 right now. And this thing was marking at, I don't know, $180 worth of profit out of the 200. And it was all going to evaporate. Well, it wouldn't evaporate unless we had a huge rally. I guess what I'm saying is, if it were 5 days from now and it was threatening the edge of the right side of the tent and you were marking somewhere in the 40 something cents out of 50 or 40 something points out of 50 on that put debit spread, I am personally looking at that as something that I can harvest now, knowing I've got a lot of put debit spread behind it. I don't really need that extra protection. I'd rather cash it in. Now, this is all subject to, because we're all new at this, and you and I are kind of on different sides of the spectrum when it comes to, you're like, I'm never harvesting this until the last day or almost the last day. And I'm like, well, if it's maxed out and it's a 50 wide put debit spread and it's somewhere marking in the 40s and you're threatening to exit the tent, but you're way up in the 40s, maybe you do want to take it off because it doesn't offer a lot more protection for the portfolio going forward. Does that kind of make sense?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you know, if I was right here.
Yeah, or anywhere in the tent where it's up there.
You know, if you're here, I mean, definitely you close.
That's what I'm saying. If the thing is so far in the tent.
It's at max profit.
Now, imagine this was Monday. If this was Monday or late last week, and this thing's marking at $198 out of $200, it doesn't have any more protection to offer because it only has two more dollars of protection left in it. It can only appreciate. So I kind of want to throw out to people, if you don't have a put debit spread that's in the, with a week to go and it's not 35 or higher, maybe you do want to just leave it alone and see where the market pushes it. But if it's clearly deep in the trap and marking very high on the potential profit level, you know, 40 something points out of 50, or in this case, $193 out of 200, I personally think yanking it off is you don't have anything more to gain. You only have something to lose. So remove it. And then again, immediately go out to your long DTE immediately and put on a fresh put debit spread so that thing can start building and working for you. So there's a little bit of discrepancy between you and I here. And this might be the discrepancy we all have as we manage our 1-1X and other portfolios, because we're all entering at different times. We all have slightly different dynamics of our portfolio. We all aren't trading the exact same portfolio. So there's going to be a little bit of nuance with each portfolio. And I think with each position in there. Now, that's me sitting here in front of my machine all day, studying it, enjoying it, and having a great time.
For the rest of the planet, I'm going to the Krispy Kreme donut shop.
That's what I'm saying. For the rest of the planet, you know, you want to go fishing or you want to go enjoy the day with your family, or if people are at work and they don't have the ability to sit here and piddle and fiddle, then by all means, I think generically you're giving the best advice. But I do want to point out for people that are trying to study this and they're thinking, well, heck, I don't want to let my fully matured put debit spread exit the tent. And I don't want to take a chance. And it might do it, say, 4 days from now when it expires. I do think there's a case for doing that. You, again, just have to realize you're removing that very mature put debit spread from your portfolio. And you really should make sure you have good backup behind it.
I think we can all, though, agree on this pretty much as a compromise. Either is going to be fine. Go by the portfolio metrics. Don't look at the individual trades at all. That's fine. Or if you're going to look at something, please only look at your closest expiration. All right, so let's just, hold on a second. I want to get those. I just want to look. Let's see what our whole position looks like.
Not I agree with the closest expiration thing, because those are the ones that are likely to be very, very mature and paying out something near max. If you have one that's not, if it's marking in the 20s or even the 30s, you probably don't want to take it off because it has a lot more potential.
Okay, y'all, let's do Theo. Here's Theo, right? This is today, right? I'm actually going to lose some of my juice here, but my juice is going to be popped to down here, right? So this is Theo, and then this is in 4 days. I know some of y'all are saying, oh my God, if he goes up a little bit, look, he's going out of profit 10 altogether. I got you. Ain't worried about it, because I love 4 days of this. Apple earnings coming out, whatever y'all think's coming out on tomorrow and Friday and today and Monday, because I got 4 days on these, right? So that brings me into what, Monday? They expire Monday. So, God, y'all look.
And again, I agree with what you're saying. And again, in this specific put debits where it's marking $80 out of a 200 total, it does have a lot of protection left to offer the portfolio. So in that specific case, if it's on that much of the edge of the tent, I would personally risk it, because if Apple does blow out or whatever, that put debit spread is going to come to life along with your others and shove profit into your portfolio where the naked puts might be working the other way.
John said, is this a PDS version of a potential problem child instead of rolling with clothes? So this is what we call the high class problem we've been talking about a lot. A lot of the issues that all of us are now facing are high class problems. Y'all, we were closing anything that was above a 65% profit. The only problem was we were doing okay with that, but it was like we were not really getting the returns that we thought we could get. We finally realized that, Cap Jones was one of the first ones of these. It said, this particular trade, guys, is designed. He looked at the design of it. He said, it's designed to go to expiration. Now, some of us can't stomach that. I got tons of naked positions in this expiration, several, right? I got some 111s, 112s, a lot of naked puts. But let me tell you something. When I look at this, I go, fall, baby, fall. Now, if it crashes, I got some problems. Then we're going to have problem children. We're going to roll out. We're going to extend duration. But, y'all, I ain't got no problem. And we've been playing the Jeffersons just about every day. So, yeah, you said the problem is not percent profit to be harvested, but the short period of time it's subject to a big move. We've had a couple of days with large up moves. Yeah, and that's why I just say, just look at the overall portfolio. How you doing? Use these things. I mean, I'm flat deltas. I got plenty of theta. I don't care where the theta comes from, right? I don't care where the theta comes in a near-term expiration or a far-term expiration. I just got to let theta decay. Theta decay is not linear, which means if I have $50 in theta, I don't get $50 of profit every day, right? I may get 20 one day, 10 the next, 80 one day. It's not linear. So, but overall, I should be averaging $40 a day in theta profits in this account. Now, what Tasty Research said is, of the premium that we sell, we should keep about 25%. And then now we have kind of figured out a way to keep more than 25% of our theta. Now, we're not collecting as much premium on the initial trade because we're trying to put debit spread. But the payoff is we get to keep a larger percentage of the overall credit. Isn't this fun? All right. So if you want to join us for the Muscadine Mafia session, come into our Discord room. If you've got any questions about that, you can post a message. I'll hang around for a few minutes while I'm getting set up about that. It is for Muscadine Mafia members, and I'm about to post the link in the Muscadine Mafia chat room. So we will see y'all in 8 minutes.